Hello, I'm Valentina Cy. We're in my bedroom for Bedroom Pop, and I will be singing Glendale. And I wrote this song because I had a lot to say about a guy. I've still got a drawer filled with your clothing. I think I'll keep it till it's eroding. Even then, I think I'll love you. I still don't. At least your sister doesn't have to see me. We never saw eye to eye. She clearly didn't like me being with you. When we were golden, she was so blue. Now I'm at the intersection, going towards Glendale. I've disconnected, 'cause I can't see your street anymore. I would crash my car right in front of your door. From you I always needed more. I've still got the socks that your dad gave me, and a song about him. I hope he won't hate me when you tell him that I gave up loving you. Got so tough. Now I'm at the intersection, going towards Glendale. I've disconnected, 'cause I can't see your street anymore. I would crash my car right in front of your door. From you I always needed more. Five weeks in London, we were dreaming, living like we'd have every season. But then it got to springtime. That's where I drew the line. Now I'm at the intersection, going towards Glendale. I've disconnected, 'cause I can't see your street anymore. I would crash my car right in front of your door. From you I always needed more.
What's up, guys? It's Troy. We're here on 10 and 60 with Valentina Cy. How are you doing?
Hey, so good. Thanks. Thanks for having me.
Of course. Why don't you tell the people where you're from?
I am from Los Angeles, basically Hollywood.
Right on. What is the most favorite thing that you own?
Favorite thing that I own? That's a great question. Can it be this water bottle?
Yeah. I actually have the same one. It's so good.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah. It keeps me extremely hydrated, and I don't know. It's like my safety blanket.
And I love it. I wish more water bottles you could just squeeze like that without having the lid and all that, you know?
Right? We're athletes.
Yeah, there you go. What was your very first memory ever?
Ooh, my first memory. I would like to think that this hasn't been told to me, but I remember just like climbing the little like
monkey bar structures in preschool in my undies, because at my preschool that I went to, everyone could just run around in their underwear. We were all very free and liberated. So
really?
That's my first memory.
There you go. If you could eat one cuisine the rest of your life, what would it be?
Italian, 1,000%. I love pasta. Yeah. Bolognese is my favorite food.
Same, I love that shit.
It's so good.
What's your biggest fear?
My biggest fear? To not create enough things. I have this constant need to be creating things, whether it's music or taking photos or crocheting or drawing, and I just have this fear that I'm not going to be productive enough when I leave this earth, and that's what I try to do every day.
Right on. Did you make that sweater that you're wearing?
No. I wish.
Damn.
I'll work up to it.
All right, there you go. And then on the flip side of that question, what would you say your biggest insecurity is?
My biggest insecurity? That I'm not able to read people the way that I think I am reading them. So, I mean, I guess it's just, you know, walking into a room and thinking everybody hates you, but it's not true. But, you know, just being self-conscious.
Oh, yeah. There you go. And what's your favorite snack?
My favorite snack, probably goldfish.
Yes,
blasted.
I love goldfish.
Yeah,
it's my favorite snack.
They're great.
I can literally eat a box. When I say box, I mean like the big Costco size jumbo box in like one sitting.
It's fully. It's the best.
They're so good.
And I feel like they're healthy-ish. Like, it's not the worst thing you could eat.
Yeah, it's definitely not the worst thing.
And it's a great airplane snack as well.
Recently, I don't know what's been going on, but I've been flying American, and they've been giving goldfish out as snacks, and I'm like, yo, whoever made this decision, fuck it.
Guess it's the new Delta.
Yeah. What would you say your best trait is?
Ooh, my best trait. My honesty,
okay.
I suppose.
It's a good one.
You know, it can be bad sometimes, but I think it's pretty good most of the time.
There you go. If there was like one thing that you learned either personally or about the world or just anything in general from last year, what would that be? Like, what did you leave last year being like, all right, this was the one thing I learned and I'm happy with that?
What did I learn last
year? Good or bad?
To enjoy the process of things, as cheesy as that sounds. Days can feel very long, especially when you were in lockdown. So just how to enjoy every moment and, you know, take time to like read a book or go outside in the sun. And yeah.
That's a great answer. I love that. Yeah, I feel like last year definitely taught everybody just to like take 10 steps back and calm down and take every day for granted. Not take every day for granted, you know?
Yeah.
Really just like live life.
Yeah.
Whatever that means in people's heads.
Yeah.
So yeah, hell yeah. And let's see. What's your favorite emotion?
My favorite emotion. Ooh, okay. I would have to say it's the feeling of, I don't know what the exact word is, but when you are, what's the word? Are there going to be edits in this?
Not really, but there can be. I can do a funny edit.
Just the feeling of being unstoppable, driving in your car and listening to your absolute favorite song, and feeling like you're on top of the world and you're the center of the universe, as bad as that sounds, but like, you know, we all do it. And
yeah,
just listening.
You gotta get in your bag.
Yeah.
Hell yeah. And what would that song be for you?
Thong Song by Cisco.
Wow. That's
a I know every song. Single lyric. It is my favorite song.
Hell yeah. And final question.
Mm-hmm.
What's your biggest dream?
My biggest dream. I have reevaluated what my dreams have meant in the last year. And I just want to say it's, well, aside from doing everything that I want to do in life, which I already am doing, you know, the things I want to do, I want to just end up in a villa in Italy, specifically in the Amalfi Coast. That's just, you know, that's like end goal dream for me, pretty much.
That's awesome. I love that. Italy's a beautiful place.
Yeah.
Beautiful people.
Yeah.
Amazing food.
They know how to live it up.
Go get it. Go get it.
Thank you. I will try.
There you have it, folks. 10 and 60, Valentina Cy. Yahoo!
Yay!